In Verilog or Systemvlog, you cannot directly assign a variable with a value or an expression by using a symbol equal to symbol. You need to use some type of assignment statements. In this movie, you'll be learning about different types of assignment statements in Verilog and Systemvlog. Before that, please subscribe us if you haven't subscribed, and also visit our website at systemvlogacademy.com to find more Systemvlog training programs and courses. Before learning the types of assignment statements, we will refresh few fundamentals of digital circuits. We will see the different types of digital circuits so that you will be able to understand Systemvlog assignment statements more detail while you go through them.
All digital circuits are classified into two types as combinational or sequential circuits. Any circuit without a memory storage element in it is called as a combinational circuit, and a circuit with a memory is called as a sequential circuit. The basic building blocks of any sequential circuits are latches and flip-flops. Both of them can store a single bit in them as long as the power is driven to them. The main difference between latches and flip-flops is that for latches, their outputs are constantly affected by their inputs as long as the enable signal is asserted. In other words, when they are enabled, their content changes immediately when their input changes. Flip-flops, on the other hand, have their content change only either at the rising or falling edge of the enabled signal. This enabled signal in case of a flip-flop will be usually the controlling clock signals. After the rising or falling edge of the clock, the flip-flop content will remain constant even if the input changes. In simple words, a sequential storage element with a clock signal will be a flip-flop, and without a clock signal will be a latch. There are four types of assignment statements in Verilog and Systemvlog. They are continuous assignment, procedural assignments, procedural continuous assignments, and net aliasing. Out of these, the last two, that is procedural continuous assignment and net aliasing, are not commonly used in programs, and therefore they are not discussed here. Also in procedural assignments, there are two subcategories called blocking and non-blocking assignments. First, we will see different assignment statements in Verilog language. So this is pure Verilog and not Systemvlog. Here is a summary of different assignment statements and the type of circuits referred by them in Verilog HDL. There are two types of assignments, which are continuous and procedural assignments. There is only one keyword that implements a continuous assignment, which is the assign keyword. The keywords that implements a procedural assignments are always, initial, final, and forever. Next, we will see when these keywords need to be used. The assign keyword is used to implement a combinational circuit in the final IC, and it cannot be used to implement a sequential circuit. An always keyword can be used to implement either a combinational circuit or a sequential circuit. The type of circuit inferred by the always block is dependent on the way in which you write the always block. You will see them in detail in coming sessions. The other procedural assignment statements, which are initial, final, and forever, should be used only in writing test bench code, and they are not synthesizable, or they should not be used in the design code.
These were the assignment statements in Verilog, and in Systemvlog, all of these types are valid, and they do the same functionality as in Verilog as well. And in addition to this, Systemvlog added three more additional procedural assignment blocks, which are always underscore comb, always underscore latch, and always underscore ff, which are very much useful in RTL coding or design coding. You will see in detail about all this towards the end of this movie. Now let's go through each of these assignment statements one by one. First is continuous assignment.
The keyword assign is used for continuous assignments in Verilog and Systemvlog. In Verilog, only a wire type variable can be assigned by using these assign statements, but in Systemvlog, it can be used with a register type variable. A single assign block can only have a single statement in it. Therefore, the begin and keywords should not be used along with assign statements. The syntax for assign statement is assign variable equal to value semicolon, or variable equal to expression semicolon. Here is an example. The assign statement will always produce a combinational circuit in the final IC. Therefore, you cannot use it along with any clock signals. The name continuous assignment is derived from the fact that this block will be evaluated continuously in the simulation, and any change in the right hand side expression will reflect in the left hand side immediately. Next is procedural assignment. A procedural assignment can be used to model a sequential circuit or a combinational circuit. It can have multiple statements in it and need to be marked with a begin and keywords if there are multiple statements in it. These are the procedural assignment statements in Verilog language. Out of this, only always block is used in design coding, and flow control statements like if, else, for, case, etc. can be added to an always block to write synthesizable code. Next, you will learn about the always block in Verilog language. Remember, whatever you are learning for Verilog is also applicable for System Verilog, but we will cover System Verilog separately after Verilog. In case of Verilog or System Verilog, even if you write an always block in a wrong way to model a specific circuit, the compiler will not flag any error there, but the final circuit generated in the IC will not be the one that you have intended for. Therefore, it is very important to understand how to write always block, especially if you are writing Verilog language. In case of System Verilog, you have the flexibility of using additional keyword to specify the type of circuit, which we'll learn shortly. Here you will see about the always block in Verilog, different types of circuit produced by the always block, and the problems with the always block in Verilog. And after this, you will see about the always block in System Verilog and their extensions as well. The Verilog always procedural block is an infinite loop that repeatedly executed the statements within the loop. In order for the simulation time to advance, the loop must contain some type of timing control or event control. This can be in the form of a fixed delay represented with a hash token, a delay until an expression is evaluated as true represented with a wait keyword, or a delay until an expression changes its value represented with the @rate token. In general, you will use it with a sensitivity list in the beginning of the statement along with @rate symbol. And therefore, the generalized syntax can be written like always @rate, the sensitivity list within brackets, begin, multiple statements, and end keyword. Whenever any variable in the sensitivity list is changing its value, the block will be evaluated. And also remember that the multiple statements within the block will be evaluated sequentially. That means every time when this always block is evaluated, first statement 1 will be evaluated, then it will go to the statement 2 and so on. These are the issues with the usage of general purpose always block, and System Verilog avoids this ambiguity by adding extra types of always block for different types of circuit, which you will learn next. Next is System Verilog always blocks. These are the System Verilog additions to the general purpose always block in Verilog. The always comp is used to specify a combinational circuit, always underscore latch for a latched logic, and always underscore ff for flip-flops. Now we will see them in detail. Always underscore comp. The always comp construct in System Verilog is added to indicate to the synthesizing tool that the intention of the designer is to infer a combinational circuit with the statements in it. Unlike the general purpose always procedural block, you don't need to specify a sensitivity list with always underscore comp. The combinational logic sensitivity list can be automatically inferred because the software tools knows that the intent is to represent a combinational logic. An important advantage of always comp over the general purpose always procedural block is that when always comp is specified, the designer intent is clearly stated. Software tools no longer need to examine the content of the procedural block to try to infer what type of logic the engineer is intended to model. Instead, software tools can examine the content of the procedural block and issue any warnings or errors if it is used in a wrong way. That means if the circuit written within the always comp is finally inferring a large circuit, the tool can give you a warning or error. Another common confusion while learning System Verilog after Verilog is the always underscore comp and the always @rate star representation. In Verilog, the always @rate of star is commonly used to specify that this is a combinational circuit. In the first look, you might think that both always @star and the always comp are identical, but they are not. I'm not going to the details of why they are not identical, but it is strongly recommended to use always underscore comp to write a combination circuit in system verilog instead of always at the star. I hope you have learned enough theory, and let's now look at some examples. Here is a general purpose always block with an if statement in it, and think about the circuit that is generated by this code. The code says if enable is high, y will be equal to A, otherwise y will be equal to B. Thus, it will be a combinational circuit consisting of two logic gates that propagates A to Y when enable is high or B to Y when enable is low. Here is the circuit. Now, if you use the system verilog specific always underscore comp block instead of always at star like this, again the output will be the same as that of using the always at star in this case. The only advantage that might seem here is the synthesizing tool need not to go to the code and decode it in order to identify the type of circuit. Now let's slightly modify the code within the always block. Assume that by mistake you forgot to add the else part of the if statement in the program. Your intention is to produce a combinational circuit by writing this logic, but by mistake you've missed the else part. We'll see the difference between using always at star and always comp in this case. When you use the verilog always at star in this case, even though you expect to infer a combinational circuit, it will not do that. If you go through the code and decode it, it says that make a circuit that changes whenever enable or A is changing, and also assign A to Y when enable is high. In other words, this description does not say anything about the change to Y when enable is low. Therefore, the synthesizing software will decode it as keep the value of Y as same when enable is low. This is nothing but a latch which will change its output when the enable is present and store it otherwise. Thus, instead of inferring a combinational circuit, the result will be a sequential circuit with a latch as shown here. Now, if you use the always underscore comp instead of the verilog always at star, in the same case, the software tool will issue an error or warning because it is detecting a sequential circuit generated within a combinational construct always underscore comp. This is why you should use specific constructs for combinational, latch and flip-flop. In this example, if your actual intention was to generate a latch, you should use the always underscore latch keyword instead of the always underscore comp keyword. Next is always underscore latch. The always latch procedural block is used to indicate that the intent of the procedural block is to model latch based logic. And finally, it is always underscore FF. The always FF keyword is used to indicate that the designer is intended to model synthesizable sequential logic with flip-flops. When you use the always FF keyword, you should always specify whether the circuit should change its value on the positive edge or the negative edge of the clock or the signals. Therefore, you should always use either a positive edge or the negative keyword along with the clocking signal or any other signal that is used within this always FF block. Here is a sample code that uses always FF, which produces a resettable flip-flop. This can be considered as a generalized example to produce a flip-flop with asynchronous reset. You can see that the sensitivity list is explicitly written as positive edge of clock and negative edge of reset. Whenever the positive edge of clock or negative edge of reset is detected, this block will be evaluated. If it is because of a negative edge of reset, the output will be assigned with a zero. If this is evaluated on the positive edge of clock, then the output will be assigned with the value of the input D. If both of these triggering events, that is the positive edge of clock and the negative edge of reset, is happening, then always a reset is getting preference because it is written first here and the else part will not be evaluated. This will generate a resettable flip-flop with asynchronous reset. Now in the same code, if you increase the width of the input and the output variable D and Q to say 4, it will generate a 4-bit storage element in the circuit. So here the input is 3 down to 0D and the output is 3 down to 0Q as well. This will generate a 4-bit storage element in the circuit, and this can be extended to any number of bits according to the functional requirement of the circuit. Now you have learned all about continuous assignment and procedural assignments in Verilog and system Verilog. And here is a summary. In the final IC, your intention is to produce either a combinational circuit or a sequential circuit, and the sequential circuit could be either a flip-flop or a latch. To produce a combinational circuit, you can use either the assign keyword or the always underscore comp keyword in system Verilog. And to produce a sequential logic, if your intention is to produce a latch, you should use the always underscore latch keyword. And if your intention is to produce a flip-flop, you should use the always underscore ff keyword. And along with all the always blocks, that is always comp, always latch and always ff keywords, you can use these keywords in system Verilog or these type of blocks in system Verilog, which are if, case, for, while, break, continue and a function. In general, if you are writing system Verilog RTL design code, you should not use a simple always block. You should always specify whether it is a combinational circuit by using the always comp logic, or a latch logic by using the always latch keyword, or it is a flip-flop by using the always ff keyword. But in test bench coding, the general purpose always block is used along with other procedural blocks like initial, final and forever. The initial block will be evaluated only at the start of the simulation. The final block will be evaluated when the simulation is ended. And the forever block is something similar to an always block, that is continuously getting executed like an infinite loop in the simulation.
That is all about the assignment statements in system Verilog and Verilog. I hope this was relevant for you and you have learned something from this. If you like the video, please subscribe us, and also visit our website at systemverilogacademy.com to find more system Verilog training programs and courses. Thank you for watching.